Returnal's atmosphere is impeccably designed,
luring its players deeper into its oppressive and alien world. But due to a flaw in game design theory in general, this effect unfortunately diminishes over time. And in today's episode, we're going to be covering the game design techniques that actually make this possible. So spoiler warning from this point onwards, guys, and welcome to the anatomy of Returnal. Before we dive headfirst into Returnal's atmosphere design, we first need to define what atmosphere actually is. It's the pervading tone or mood of a place, situation, or creative work. In short, it's the vibe, be it horrific, comedic, or adventurous. But Returnal's atmosphere is alien. Every aspect of its design, from its narrative, level design, or gameplay, are all attempting to champion this alien atmosphere. Narratively, both Selene and the player at the beginning of the game are in the same boat, well, not physically, but metaphorically, shipwrecked on an unknown planet, attempting to understand this hostile and alien world, as they delve deeper into its depths with no weapons and no guidance, eventually happening upon your own course, voice logs left from a previous or future you, Lovecraftian soliloquies warning of horrific things to come. Its levels enveloped in this thick volumetric fog, concealing its twisting and turning corridors, keeping the player guessing, driving them deeper into its gargantuan otherworldly structures. Its fauna and even its architecture pulsate with a heartbeat that bleeds into the controller itself. Even simple gameplay systems, mundane adverbs in other games, become their own mysteries to solve in Returnal, having to scan every single new alien artifact to decipher how it may serve you in gameplay, decoding the language of this long-forgotten race to be able to read its histories and hints. And what does this, or any of this, do? These gameplay systems each mirror this alien atmosphere and mystery, but as the player progresses, this mystery inevitably fades. Returnal does such a beautiful job of establishing such a heavy and oppressive atmosphere, but struggles to maintain it. This happens with so many other games, not due to any fault of the developers themselves, but with a fundamental flaw in game design that we are still trying to overcome today, with the illusion of games. Designing games is like crafting an illusion, feigning depth, non-linearity, and choice to distract the player from the fact that each and every experience they are having is completely manufactured, attempting to keep this illusion alive for as long as we can. And the most important aspect of this illusion is the FTUX, the first time user experience. These first moments are where the illusion is at its most powerful, and I'm sure we all have memories of the first time we played a game. The possibilities and scale of the world feel gargantuan, but as we begin to play and learn, this illusion fades. You now know the boundaries of the world and the game's limitations. This is why it is super important to have a strong FTUX, because the developers are never going to have this opportunity again. And Returnal's FTUX is spot on, introducing its systems and world at a precise pace to keep this alien atmosphere alive as long as they possibly can. But this cannot last forever. Films can keep its viewers on the edge of their seat from beginning to end, but games find this infinitely harder due to the one aspect that sets the two mediums apart, the ability to interact. The player will eventually subconsciously distill everything down into its core gameplay function over time, because it's human nature to optimize and solve mysteries. Things that were once alien become mundane. Mysterious altars become shops. Hostile alien tendrils grasping from the void become ropes to climb. The pulsating monoliths become upgrade systems. It's hard to make a game feel alien when the mechanics don't. Many players cannot help approaching a game as an optimization puzzle. What gives the most reward for the least risk? What strategy provides the highest chance, or even a guaranteed chance, of success? Given the opportunity, players will optimize the fun out of a game. Except in this instance, players aren't optimizing out the fun, but the atmosphere overall, filtering out the aesthetic components of the game which aren't relevant to the gameplay systems they're interacting with. The illusion of this foreboding world and its characters are broken down into their most basic form. And this isn't any fault of the developers or even the players themselves, it's just inevitable due to the interactable and competitive nature of games. But how do we, as developers, delay or even fix this? In its simplest form, after this illusion fades, we have to do enough to make gameplay enough. The enjoyment of discovering these mechanics out and then developing mechanical mastery and using them to your advantage is its own separate reward. But what if we want our atmosphere cake and eat it too? Well, then it's a little bit more complicated. In order to maintain atmosphere, a game needs to refresh it, both mechanically and aesthetically. This kind of mechanical progression can be seen in many successful games like Celeste, Doom Eternal, or Inscription, which we covered in the anatomy of Inscription, which constantly change the rules throughout gameplay to subvert mechanical expectations, taking mechanical designs that all players are familiar with and then flipping them on their head, keeping the player guessing and subsequently keeping its atmosphere alive for the duration of the game. The Binding of Isaac does this in a different way, by consistently withholding information from its players. The player is always learning, but always kept mechanically guessing, something that Returnal attempted to do, but where Returnal fades away, Isaac commits to it. When the player picks up a new item, it could be beneficial or it could be the end of your run. You never know. And yes, atmospheres can change as the game progresses, from mystery to mastery, but the mechanics of the game need to continually evolve in tandem to this vibe, unless the developers want to risk inducing ludonarrative dissonance. And unfortunately, Returnal doesn't refresh its atmosphere around its mechanics, and eventually just becomes The Legend of Zelda with a diegetic respawn mechanic and a gun. But what do you think? Are there any games that you've played that have maintained their unique atmosphere throughout the entire experience, and your reasons for why you believe this worked? Let me know down below, because I would love to discuss this with you. Returnal's atmosphere may diminish over time, but its first 5 to 10 hours are intoxicating. And once it does fade, it's replaced with an engaging progression and combat system to keep its players entertained while they attempt to break this loop. Keeping the illusion of games alive is tricky business, but the most compelling part of it all is the illusion of choice, and I have a big episode planned on that, and if you would like to see it, let me know down below.
Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed today's episode, and I just want to say a big thank you to Escapist and my wonderful patrons for actually making this possible. And if you too do enjoy this series and you want to see more, I actually have my own channel with lots of similar content over there, and I can't wait to see you over there as well as on here on The Escapist. Thank you so much for the support, mate. I'll see you in the next one.